Good evening. Police have had the heart-wrenching task of combing through the crime scene on a remote property where their friends and workmates were killed just days ago. Officers had to conduct a meticulous search for potential booby traps laid by a family of survivalists making their last stand.
Step by step, police officers traced the final movements of their fallen colleagues, reenacting a cold-blooded ambush that ended in the deaths of innocent neighbour Alan Dare and two young police officers, Constable Rachel McCrow and Constable Matthew Arnold. Their families today offered some comfort.
It is important that I see the families. It's important that I tell them how proud we are of their children.
Survivors of the shootout, Constable Randall Kirk and partner Keely Bruff, now both out of hospital and no doubt processing the ferocious firefight. The evidence of just how ferocious it was, clear and confronting. Rapid gunfire, a sound neighbour Michelle will never forget.
I heard two very distinct shots and then four shots in quick succession after that. The silence made the sound travel, so yeah, they were very clear.
Riddled with bullet holes, the armoured police Bearcat, now removed from the remote property, which was reportedly fortified with foxholes, surveillance cameras, barricades, guns, and off the grid with solar energy. Nathaniel, Gareth and Stacey Train called themselves sovereign citizens, paranoid and obsessed with extreme conspiracy theories, including anti-vax beliefs, and cut off from their own family.
I'm not responsible for my two boys. They severed their relationship with us 23 years ago.
Their relationship with authorities is less clear-cut, but four Queensland officers were sent to respond to a missing persons report requested by New South Wales Police.
Those officers were responding to a routine job. They were ambushed and they were executed, and that will be investigated.
The investigation here in Queensland is now focused on how and why police were led to such a well-planned ambush. And was that missing person report in New South Wales part of an elaborate ruse designed to lead them 40 kilometres away to the remote property?
The trains were all once employed by Education Queensland. Nathaniel had taught disadvantaged children in Cairns and in Walgett, New South Wales, where he was adored.
It is just so hard to comprehend that it's the same person we're talking about.
I certainly remember around 10 years ago sitting across the desk from Nathaniel Train as a school principal. It's very difficult for me and so many people to reconcile that person with the person who was part of this horrific act.
Stacey was a respected school principal, but on Monday night she was shot dead alongside her husband and lover, his brother.
Can't give any excuse or any reasons to why this has occurred.
Their twisted ideas leading to six deaths, families and a country left in mourning. Of course, the ripple of this goes right through the police force, not only in Queensland, but really right around the world. And for the local officers here at the Chinchilla Police Station, they're trying their best just to get on with their job, to be professional, to carry out their duties as they think of their fallen mates and those who survived. They approach each routine job, I guess you have to understand, with that little bit of extra fear tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks for that, Steve Hart in Chinchilla. Now to Robert Ovadia, who's in Wieambilla tonight. Rob, surviving officers have been overwhelmed by the support.
Yeah, absolutely, Max. This tragedy has really realigned the focus of communities right across Queensland about what it is exactly that police do for us all. And the surviving officers have been showered in attention and respect and adoration, not only from their colleagues and friends and obviously families, but also total strangers. Now, today, as police methodically went about this property behind me to piece together exactly what happened a couple of days ago, the surviving officers themselves are trying to piece together their lives.
Constable Randall Kirk has a reason to smile. He's out of surgery and alive to see the birth of his child. But he has a lot to process.
He's obviously giving thought to what has occurred. Very grateful to be here.
From his hospital bed today, I'm feeling fine, just a little sore. My main thoughts are with the other police families at this awful time. It means a lot to know the community cares for us all. His boss visited him today to say thank you.
gave him and his wife a big hug and told him that I'm grateful that he's with us.
Although now is not considered the right time, 7 News understands the police officers will all be nominated for bravery awards. And tonight we can reveal more details about the extraordinary heroism shown by the team's rookie.
Keely Brough, once a personal trainer at Deception Bay, graduated from the academy in October. As the 28-year-old hid in scrub, her colleagues dead and flames around her to flush her out, the young constable kept feeding intel and kept her body camera recording. It emits a constant beep and could have given away her position. She kept it rolling regardless to document what she expected could be her own death.
Her courage and bravery was pure instinct, something that cannot be taught, and I hope she has a long and successful career within the police.
Two of the bravest in the eyes of their community.
Any officer, regardless of old or young, don't deserve that. They're all brave officers.
They've had some training in those type of, well, you never get that sort of training, I guess, but they would have been scared for their life, no doubt.
Whatever they need, the police family will provide that.
Scared for their life, but willing to sacrifice it to protect each other and their community. In Wieambilla, Robert Ovadia, 7 News.
The loss of these police officers has ripped through more than just one town or two families. The grief has swept across the state. Tributes to Matthew Arnold and Rachel McCrow are steadily growing throughout Queensland with messages of love and thanks.
At Queensland's Police Memorial, tributes for two of the state's finest. The Premier leading a stream of dignitaries honouring their service and their ultimate sacrifice.
Police Constable Rachel McCrow and Police Constable Matthew Arnold were performing their duties as police officers in the Tara Police Division when they were senselessly shot and killed.
A loss felt by the state, but especially by their brothers and sisters in blue. At a service in Townsville, emotions were raw. Constable Bree Lockyer wiping away tears. She graduated with Rachel just last year.
Rachel was an outstanding person and had those characteristics to which we like to see in a police officer.
Courage, a community spirit and a desire to help others. All attributes acknowledged at similar services across the state. Outside the Callum Vale Station, the home region of Matthew Arnold, a candlelit vigil and words from a grieving friend.
We that are left shall never forget. Rest in peace, friend and colleague.
The public sending love and support to all who wear a badge, hugs and chocolates to say thanks.
They're lovely people. They come to work, they just do their job. And they don't realise the impact they have on people.
An impact felt in the community of Tara, where Matthew and Rachel served. Today, more came to lay flowers.
To see the way that this incident has affected the community shows you how much they were held in high regard.
That same regard shone in light. Bridges and buildings bathed in blue and white here and around the country. The respect was obvious.
New places of tribute are popping up across the state, and as people continue to come to pay their respects, plans are beginning to take shape for a final farewell. The families of Matthew and Rachel are in discussions with Queensland Police chaplains about their wishes for a fitting funeral.
A heartbreaking task, deciding how to say goodbye to your child. Online, Matthew's mum posting a simple message: rest in peace, my beautiful boy. And from a stranger, a 7-year-old girl, another message.
Izzy decided to write a letter to encourage them to stay strong and that we're thinking of them.
In a time, they'll need support. Joel Dry, 7 News.
We're learning more about the neighbour who drove towards danger trying to help. Harry Clark, Alan Dare is being remembered as a hero.
And a loving family man, Max, in a cruel twist of fate. Today would have been his 26th wedding anniversary. But as we know, Alan Dare was shot dead, gunned down, shot in the back as he went onto that property to try and fight the fires that had been lit by the killers. Today we spoke exclusively to Alan's stepson as their family grapples with their devastating loss.
A husband, dad, Poppy to his 6 grandchildren, and a neighbour who died trying to help.
Horrific. It was a terrible death.
Alan Dare drove to the property knowing something was wrong.
He went to help the neighbours because he thought there was a fire. you know, and heard bangs, maybe like something, you know, that the house is on fire.
He was gunned down, shot in the back from 150 metres away, never knowing the full extent of the horror that was unfolding.
He was my father. He raised me, but not blood, but he, without him, I wouldn't be me.
Today would have been the former meat worker and truck driver's 26th wedding anniversary. Wife Kerry, the love of his life.
And what will you miss about Alan?
Knowing I don't have to worry about my mum. Like, I never had to worry about her. She was always safe, always happy. He'd be waiting hand and foot at the door of the car to help her out every day.
But she had to wait, says Corey, for 13 hours to see his body. And that, he says, added to her trauma.
If he was a hero, like the police officers, why wasn't he given the same treatment? Those police officers deserve the treatment they're getting. Like, they were good people. They'll have nothing wrong with them whatsoever. They were heroes as well. But it's just the fact that he didn't get the same treatment.
As they learn more, the town the couple adopted is grateful for his actions.
That's the type of people that we have here. They're very resilient.
7 News spoke to Kerry Dare, who said she and Alan moved to their property 3 years ago. They only planned to stay temporarily but got stuck here during COVID lockdowns. During that time, they came to love the Tara district and decided to call it home.
How's, you know, gold? What else can you say, you know, about the man? I reckon he was a damn good man and I feel very sorry for the loss.
I think he should be recognised a bit more too.
Not very many people would do that under the circumstances. He should be a hero as well, I think.
To his family and all of Queensland, he always will be. Harry Clark, 7 News.
And Queenslanders who want to support the families of the two murdered constables can help by donating to the police union's Remembrance Fund. Details can be found on our Facebook page. There's also a fundraiser for the family of neighbour Alan Dare. It's already raised more than $40,000.